Welcome to the Sons of Cities podcast. Be wary, travelers, for we use curse words. Lots of them, too. My name's Cody.
And I'm Dusty. And today, the long-awaited... Just kidding. We're making a beginner's guide to the Elder Scrolls Online.
Yeah.
But before that, to Cody with the news.
News. We have so much news. And by so much, I mean we have, like, two things.
It's the news with Cody.
So, going off of our last news, the Mid-Year Mayhem event has been going on, and it's been going sick. I got two drops of the outfit styles so far. I'm going to be playing more Battlegrounds tonight to try and get more.
I have not gotten any.
You haven't gotten any?
No.
How many have you been playing? A lot of Battlegrounds, or just a little bit?
Not very much.
Not very much.
Not even
a lot. Well, you should. And that's going until...
I haven't exactly had a lot of time, if I'm being perfectly honest. I'm in the middle of moving. So, haven't had a lot of time. But I'm planning on at least a couple hours tonight, hopefully.
Well,
pure Battlegrounds.
The good news is you have until August 6th at 10 a.m., Dusty. So you've got plenty...
Holy cow!
Plenty of time to go for that. So the Mid-Year Mayhem is going on. Obviously, you get the cool little boxes that go along when you do... the Battlegrounds or
boxes.
Any of the quests in Cyrodiil.
Like
I think you get it, yeah, and I think you get them for other stuff in Cyrodiil too.
Wow. Alliance War or Battlegrounds?
In both. You get them in the Battlegrounds boxes and you get
them
in the Alliance War too.
Excuse me. It's at any PvP game mode, right?
And you get 100%, and you get 100% XP boost if you use that little scroll. So the biggest thing for me was making sure I got Warhorn on my healer. For the assault class, because I don't play a whole lot of PvP, but Warhorn's really good in PvE. Probably good in PvP too, I would think. But still, it's a good ultimate for a healer. So if you're looking to do that, and if you're looking to make a healer, you probably really want Warhorn. And this is probably the best time to go grind to get it. Especially if you're a Nightblade and you want Caltrops too. That's another one that's important.
It's just one of those events.
It's one of those things. Well, it's one of those things that you've got to get if you want to do that kind of setup. So
this is a good
time to do it because you get 100% XP boost.
Not only that,
faster.
It's not just a weekend. It's like 2 weeks.
Yeah.
August 6th. That's what? Another week. A full week of possibilities.
Yeah. Lots of possibilities.
Get that PvP going.
Yeah, it's a good time. And then return to Orsinium, Dusty. You remember that place?
When I played on the PlayStation.
Home of the Orcs.
A while back, Orsinium had... just come out, I believe.
No.
Orsinium was the first place I went to then, because that's the only memory I have of the PlayStation was Orsinium and how cool I thought the city was.
Yeah.
But, yes. I'm glad we're returning. I love it. Yeah.
That area is the DLC?
Yeah,
because
I think the first character I made was a Daggerfall Covenant character.
And that's
like the first place you go to. It's like the Auradon of
the
DC. Daggerfall Covenant, you know?
Yeah. It's a cool place.
I love it. It's such an awesome city. It's very difficult to navigate because there's 90 levels.
Yeah, they're really cool. So if you don't have the Orsinium DLC, then it's only going to be 750 crowns to buy it if you're not a
ESO Plus
member, which is crazy. It's 75% off what it originally was, which is pretty crazy. They are going to have the Orsinium's Collector's Bundle again. Which they did originally, which is cool. It's going to be 2,000 crowns, which is 60% off. It's going to come with the Fearsome Cave Bear Mount, a Cave Bear Cub Pet, and 5 Crown Experience Scrolls.
5? God damn. That's a lot of scrolls.
Yeah, which is pretty cool. In tandem with the DLC Game Pack, the Pariah's Pinnacle Home and the Malakath's Chosen Furnishing Pack are returning to the in-game crown store for the duration of event. So if you miss those... And they're coming back, which is cool. The home in Orsinium is coming back, which is cool. I think this is good, just setting kind of a precedent, to be honest, because like I was super worried that like some of the stuff that I really wanted that was only in the Crown Store for a limited time, and I'm kind of like, fuck, man, I want to get that.
Limited time doesn't always mean
like I want
time.
That Telvanni style that's like the fucking samurai style. I want that shit, and I totally forgot. I was going to get it, dude, and I totally forgot to get it.
Well,
and it's fucking annoying.
On the bright side, limited time doesn't mean only time. So
yeah, so hopefully it'll come back.
We'll see.
I think the Telvanni like has come back more than once, but
it's
I don't know.
Dope style.
It is really cool. Hopefully it'll come back.
I've actually seen a lot of people using it recently. because
yeah.
it's dope.
Yeah, that's way cool. So in addition to the on sale, the DLC game pack, any brave adventurers who venture into Hrothgar will enjoy a host of bonuses rewards for doing activities in the zone. So you'll get double items harvested from crafting nodes, which is pretty fucking cool. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So if you're one of those guys that grinds around for crafting materials and sells them off for gold, if that works for you, then holy shit, go to fucking Hrothgar. Yeah. Double rewards received from chests in Maelstrom Arena, both for vet and normal. Holy shit. So if you are trying to get the Maelstrom bow or the other Maelstrom weapons that are mm-hmm, coveted as mm-hmm. fuck, holy shit, that's the time to do it, because you're going to get double drops.
Yeah.
So you have double the percentage to get the one you want with the trait you want without having to transmute it, which is super cool. Double the number of reward boxes received for completing the daily quests.
Jesus.
Which is also really cool. So they're doubling a whole lot of shit. Which that's pretty much it for the return to Orsinium.
Bring the people back to Orsinium, baby.
Yeah, which is super cool.
We love it.
And then, Dusty, so I know we've got Twitch drops on here. Will you remind me exactly how those work again?
Twitch drops.
Twitch drops are back.
Certain streamers who play Elder Scrolls Online have drops enabled. So if you're watching a Twitch streamer who's playing Elder Scrolls Online, you have a chance to get free loot. But if you don't want to wait for your chance or watch streamers for 10 hours or however long their random algorithm is, if you buy crowns, a game expansion, a DLC, just the game through a Twitch streamer, you get an exclusive Twitch crate for Twitch emotes, and you get a little ESO badge on your Twitch, and then you get an in-game crate, and you get whatever you purchase. So it's
nice. And it's like a special Twitch. The crate you get in ESO is like a special crate, right? It's not like the Sigic ones. It's like a Twitch crate that has special.
It's a specific special crate that's unique,
which
to,
is super
to
cool.
The Twitch.
So it's got like super unique stuff in it, because you can only get like one.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You can't get multiple. You can only get one, right?
It's only one.
That's fucking crazy.
But if you're watching a streamer, you always have a chance to win free loot. That's the cool part about the Twitch drops, right? Is you always have that chance to get the extra loot.
Right. Which is super cool.
Yeah.
So
ESO marketing game is on point.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Get there. Watch those Twitch streamers.
Yeah. So next we're going to be talking about a set that Dusty has been using recently for our set review. We're going to review a set for you from ESO from people that don't know a lot about ESO. Well, I guess like I have two max characters now.
I have
Does
one.
That make me, am I in?
You're not
I
there
noob
yet.
Still?
I don't think you're there yet.
Well, I'll read it and then you can tell me about it if that's cool.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
So it's the Shroud of the Lich set.
Now, pay attention here. I have a cool story, okay? If you check out last week's episode, Cody talks about how I'm a certain mage that enjoys the necromancy. And he even said...
You're a fan.
He even said, your ultimate goal as a necromancer is to become a lich. And so...
Which is true, that's what necromancers want to do.
Little old me went on to the Elder Scrolls Wiki and looked for a set that had the word lich in it. I found this Shroud of the Lich set. I found a video on it. Said it was really good for the Somerset PvE. Weird coincidence that this all happened right now.
So guess what, Dusty? You're a fucking lich now.
I'm a lich. I'm an actual lich. I am a max
Dusty
level lich.
Dusty is doing a lich build.
Shroud of the Lich, baby.
So it's light armor. It's in the lich style, which I gotta say is looking pretty cool.
It's pretty dope.
It's pretty cool looking.
You get it in both of the Crypt of Hearts dungeons.
Normal and vet.
Normal and
vet. I thought it was just Crypt of Hearts 1.
Nope. 1 and 2.
It's in 1 and 2.
Because in 2, the final boss is Narianeth, where you get that lightning staff. Narianeth's Forsaken Staff.
Oh, dude, that staff looks so cool, too. Mm-hmm. Is that the one that you have?
No. That's the one I've been trying to get.
Oh, you haven't.
I've done that dungeon
yet?
Like 4 times, and it's never dropped.
Yeah, you got to do it more times than that.
I know. I'm a DPS, so I queue for 20 minutes. And...
I'll come play with my new maxed healer. I'll come play it, and we can grind it.
All right. Shroud of the Lich. Let's go through it.
So, yeah, Shroud of the Lich. So, it is a 5-piece set. So, these are the legendary champion 160 stats. Mm-hmm. So, for 2 items, you'll get 129 to your Magicka recovery.
Big numbers.
For 3 items, you get 1,096 to your max Magicka. For four items, you get another 129 to your max, or to your magical recovery, excuse me. And for five items,
the big boy.
When you fall below 33% magicka, increase your magicka recovery by 1,032 for 20 seconds. This effect can occur once every 1 minute.
Yeah. Big boy numbers right there. So the big part about this set, at least for me, is it's huge into sustaining your magicka.
Yeah.
It's a big magicka sustain. It adds a lot to your recovery, a little bit to your max. The big part is that fifth item.
Yeah,
that under 33%, when you're in a crunch, you're in a bind, and you can't hold your heavy attack, and you're under 33%, and you see that nice little, that little extra spurt that just bounces into your magicka bar, and you can reel off your rotation. It's great. Huge.
Well,
max.
Just hearing this to me, because like I really like using. Are you using potions and stuff in your rotation? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because that's one thing I've been trying to weave in. Because I've
not
been
not
really
too
using...
much, honestly.
Well,
because
now I'm using like the weapon. Fuck, I forgot the essence of like weapon power or some shit that I'm using for my Nightblade to keep it active all the time. But that to me would think like, okay, so at the beginning of the fight, you should make your magicka go all the way down and then to where it's below 33%, and then you see that proc hit, right? And then you take a potion to bring it back up. Well, now you've got 20 seconds that you can just let fucking loose.
Yeah.
Right?
That's,
and then once it's gone, then you have a chance, you want to get it back down to try and proc it, and then...
Yeah, that's actually funny you mentioned that. That's in the video I watched about it.
Oh, really?
It's like you
well,
use
it makes
all
sense
of it,
you
and then
make
you just...
it...
beef it back up, and for 20 seconds you just go for it
because you have insane
fluid rotations,
because you'll have like 3,000 magicka recovery or some shit. If your magicka recovery is already really good, then like holy shit, you have a bunch of magic. Well,
you've already got
3,
the extra
000, but
you've already got the
lot
extra
of
what
recovery.
What's 129 times 2, whatever, 148, 158 big maths, quick maths,
258
Quick maths. All right, that's it. Shroud of the Lich.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's a pretty sweet set.
There's some jewelry pieces, some staves. We don't really need to go into those, though. But, yeah.
Either way you want to use it, though, it's on everything, so it's pretty
Crypt
cool.
Crypt of Hearts, you can either get
well, I guess it
that
doesn't have,
set.
Like, a resto staff, does it? It's just the lightning one?
No, it's got two rings.
Oh, these are all the... Well, yeah, it's got rings. Oh, and then it's got the staff. Yes, it's got a destruction staff.
Yeah, so in the Crypt of Hearts, you can either... the Shroud of the Lich set is a drop, or the Leviathan set will drop, which is a medium set. I saw that a lot.
Is it like a stamina set or something?
Yeah, it's a stamina sustain. That's a lot of S's.
Hmm.
But,
stamina.
Yeah, Shroud
stamina.
Of the Lich. That's
stamina
our set of the week. And it's certainly been my set of the week.
Yeah, it's been pretty
sustaining
sweet.
Sustaining that magic.
All right, Dusty, let's head on next. What you been up to in ESO, Dusty? What you been doing?
You gonna do the song? What have you been up to?
What have you been up to?
In ESO.
ESO.
Why, you kind of lost that note there for a second, but let's move on. What have I been up to? Well, big news from my camp. My first max level character has been achieved.
What do you do now? You hit max, what do you do?
Not quite sure yet. Still figuring it out.
Figure it out. Do all the cool stuff.
Yeah, all the cool stuff I've been watching Cody do. I'm like,
well, now you hit the point. What's cool about finally hitting max level is it just like almost you just like, ah, finally I can do all the cool shit that everyone talks about.
I know, and then there's so much that you're like,
finally I get to find out what Mav Lorikaj is. What the fuck is that shit?
Oh, and now I'm level 50 and I'm like,
what is white gold?
There's
tower?
So much I can do. Which one to pick?
Vet dungeons. What is this?
What is that?
What is
dies
this
in 30
of?
Seconds.
Dies in 30 seconds.
Not for me.
That's accurate. That's the first time I joined a vet dungeon. I was like,
then, yeah, treated it like a regular four person.
Well, I still hadn't like figured out like food and stuff yet, so I like didn't have food and no one told me, which now I'll get on and like notice if someone has like 12k health or some shit, and I'll like, hey, let's make sure everyone's got food, and sure enough that one guy like, oh fuck, and like
oh fuck,
which is like, thanks, and dude. I've done that before, even now, where I'll like go through a dungeon and I'm like, why the fuck do I keep dying in these stupid ass fights, and then I'll look down and I'm like, oh, embarrassing. I'm gonna hurry up and eat some food.
Eat me a chicken wing.
eat some of this
National Chicken Wing
steamed
Day.
Vegetables here. Get back up here. Or I'll like run out of stamina or magic real up fast. Here. I'm like, fuck. So cool. So you hit level 50.
Level 50. I'm so CP what have you been 50 doing now? Right about now. Dungeons. Delves.
Just been doing the Undaunted Pledges and shit, haven't you?
Undaunted Pledges a lot.
You hit those monster sets.
Trying to. I keep getting medium drops. I don't use any medium. I am completely light armor. Which I think I want to do a heavy helmet.
The nice part about, well yeah, heavy armor is fucking, maybe the Juggernaut passive is fucked. It's
maybe at some point.
So yeah, I run one, right now I'm running two pieces of heavy armor on my healer just so to use Juggernaut because it's a good passive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I've been doing a couple battlegrounds.
Well, the nice part I really like, the thing I really like about the vet dungeons is that they have the final boss has a 100% chance to drop the monster helmet. So like if you've been doing the Undaunted Pledges for a while and you have a bunch of fucking shoulders and you're like, God damn, I want to fucking use one of these sets. You just look up like one of the shoulders you have, what dungeon it is, and then you see if you can do that one on vet. And if you can, just go fucking, if as long as you can beat it, you know, like as long as you have a group that's worth a shit, then you can.
Hopefully.
I honestly haven't run into like any problems with groups for the
most
part.
Do you solo queue vet dungeons or do you like find a group in a guild or something?
Well, I'll find a group in a guild if I'm like grinding for a specific one.
Like some people to help you farm?
Well, it depends on, if I'm playing on my DPS, then I kind of have to like get in, because I don't want to wait 6 hours if it's like late at night, because I tend to play late at night or whatever, you know?
We all do, don't we?
Yeah, well, like, so if it is, then yeah, I'll get in like my guild, one of the guilds, and see if anyone's doing dungeons or anything.
Yeah, join a guild. Save a life. Save your life.
Save your life. That's a good thing to do when you hit level 50, or even before that, is to join a guild.
Any point. If you ever need tips, dude, hit up your guild.
Yeah. So I hit my healer level 50 today, actually.
We're all hitting 50.
So I've been like, I've been figuring out his gear and like figuring out what to do with him.
What is your favorite part about healing? Because I have to know. I've only made DPSs in ESO so far.
Well, you've made a tank, but like,
oh, that was,
you haven't like really played it though.
You're talking about like, Frogmog?
Well, I just like
my orc.
Your orc, yeah.
Frogmog.
I don't know. Like, it's just like I like making sure everyone is chill. Like, I don't know. I like, it's like a little bit more responsibility because you have to keep everyone alive. You know what I mean? Like.
Hmm.
I don't know. It's hard to like quantify, I guess, but like, I just like being a little bit more responsible and
but
eventually
not the tank.
Well, I'm like working up to that. Cause like, I do really want a tank. But I'm just kind of working up to it, I guess.
Yeah.
Cool. So
I've never been a healer. I really want to try one.
It's honestly, I really like it. It's like, it's not, I think the thing I like about it too, is not that I don't like doing a rotation, but I like kind of having to react to things to like, cause
like
I'll put down my hots.
Set.
Well, yeah. Cause I'll like, really what I'll do is I'll put down my hots on everybody and then I'll do DPS or I'll debuff the boss that we're going after or whatever. Cause that's the big thing too, is not just healing, but debuffing things buffing your group too. Cause like you'll do buffs and heal over times and like make sure you're debuffing the boss too. Just to help the DPS do better or to buff their DPS to do better or whatever. So so that's why I'll use like combat prayer, which will boost their DPS by like 8 or 12% or some shit. And then there's like one of the destruction staff abilities will debuff the boss too. So it just like, so not only are you healing everybody, you're also like, like major fracture, I think is the, it gives them major fracture.
You're not necessarily doing damage, but you're like fucking the boss.
Yeah. Well, I have stuff that does damage too, just if I'm like not, if I lay everything down and then I'm like, now what? Like, I'll have a spammable that I can do, like usually that big.
Well, yeah.
Because it's a
Templar,
so I'll have that
spear that I
can throw.
Sometimes I see you, all of a sudden I notice I'm the only sorcerer in there. And then I'm doing my heavy attack, and I see another lightning bolt come in, and I like look over, and I see Cody. I'm like,
yeah, because I have a lightning staff is on my back bar. Yeah. There's a lightning staff.
Back bars are lifesavers too.
Is just everything a lifesaver today for you?
Yeah, dude. Join a guild, save your life.
And then let's talk about with the event. I've been doing a lot of PvP. How about you?
I've done a couple.
You haven't joined the Alliance War or anything yet, huh?
I have not done the Alliance War yet.
You should, dude.
Ever. I watched you do one. That was kind of cool. Again, haven't had a lot of time recently, but
right.
Really looking forward. I played a few Battlegrounds, and honestly, Battlegrounds, the team deathmatch is way more interesting to me than an Alliance War. The deathmatch is so much fun.
Oh, yeah. The like, Battleground just, stuff is way
it's
awesome.
So, it just reminds me of,
it's
like...
It's so cool.
It's almost like a dungeon format, but, like,
yeah, cause you have
against
two DPS,
real people.
Because you have a 2 DPS
and it's so cool.
Heal.
Like, even when I get shit on, I'm like, I want to know how he killed me. Like, I want to know what he's doing. How is he better than me?
Right.
I just want to know. Like, it's a huge learning experience, I guess, for me.
Well, I think
I've never
breeds...
been max level or done PvP, so Battlegrounds, looking at the recaps of how you died will get you to... You'll learn abilities and skill lines so fast if you do that.
Well, and you'll learn abilities that are good for other classes, and you'll learn what those... Because I've found, like, just things that you're... You know, I mean, it's just like any game. You start to learn and notice things that's like... you know, when you hear, like in fucking Overwatch, if you hear, it's high noon, you're like,
you're
fuck!
Hiding, you're fucking, you're yeah. hiding in a corner.
What for your life? No! You know, it's like little stuff like that. Like, you'll see, like, an ultimate drop or something. Or
you
like,
see that diva
you see
bomb
someone
drop
hit
from
the
sky
yeah,
and land right in front of you.
Like, yeah, or you see someone blow their horn, and then they're coming, their team's coming at you, and you have to, like, okay, shit, they're, like, super buffed right
okay,
now.
Okay, fuck,
we need
fuck,
to probably
fuck.
Run away, or, like... Or yeah, so or blow our horn or something like that. I don't know. That sounded weird when I said what I was...
Okay,
you gotta blow the horn sometimes. That's
gotta blow.
Just gotta,
your
blow, just gotta you blow your horn.
Blow your own horn.
But don't
sometimes.
Not your own horn.
No, blow your own horn.
No, you blow others people's horns, Dustin.
Others
people's horns. You blow those.
I'm more
not,
of a blow my own
horn
kind of guy.
But yeah, honestly, I really like Battlegrounds. It's just like one of those things that not only am I learning a lot about like PvP and how much different it is than PvE mm-hmm. and just like what you want your build to
oh my
what
dude.
You want your character to be able to do.
That's one thing I said to you earlier today. I was like, dude, it's crazy how much my rotation and the abilities I use changed when I
well
started
yeah
because
with Sorks because you're just like stunning the fuck out of people in PvP.
Well, yeah
huh?
it works out really well if you have a sorcerer and a Dragon Knight as your two DPS, because I just
yeah.
stun the fuck out of him while he just spams his fire stuff that just puts out massive
dude,
damage.
Fl-
so
is
I just
it Flame Lash that's that fucking
the whip?
Busted ass? Yeah, I think it's Flame Lash is the morph that, like, it's fucking busted. It does
oh, yeah,
so
dude,
much damage.
Because when every once in a while, it's I can't remember the exact proc, but you can proc it where it'll knock them down
yeah,
no
yeah,
matter
yeah.
what.
I think that's... Is that Flame
that's
Lash?
That's Flame Lash, I think. I just got it. I think it's Flame Lash. I'm not too sure.
On your... Magicka DPS DK that you're doing?
No, my Stamina Dragon Knight.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Ooh,
he's level
be cool.
7.
That'll be cool. Oh, yeah, you, like, just started.
Yesterday, last night when we both started.
Oh, yeah.
That's another
I'm
thing
way,
we've been up
I'm
to.
I'm way further ahead of you on
well,
because
I stopped playing early
well, yeah, that's
night.
That's the next thing I want to talk about. Well, we can just... We'll go back to that. Yeah, so new characters. We started new characters,
mm-hmm,
which
mm-hmm.
is always fun. Well, I started two.
Well,
I,
you started
okay,
two in like
me,
the past 3 days.
Let me just say
days.
This. I don't think I've said this on the podcast yet. I have a horrible addiction that's called creating new characters, naming them something funny, and then never going back to
them. He also has an addiction to crowns.
To them. To crowns?
Crowns and crown crates.
Oh my god, those
please
fucking
help
crown
him.
Please, send help. Send crowns,
a penny,
actually.
A crown a day.
A crown a day. We'll keep the crates.
In my inventory.
In my, we'll keep the crates in my inventory.
In my
give
mouth.
That damn Khajiit to give me some good shit.
That extra
I'm
card.
Sick of all those stupid ass poisons and like fucking...
Crown lethal poison.
Yeah.
Woo!
Holy shit. Oh my god. It's like literally this is the best fucking poison in the entire game, dude.
It's a lethal.
Oi, have you seen
crown.
This poison? It's literally the best poison in the entire game. All you've got to do is buy one of these crown crates, mate. And it's literally the best poison in the game. I swear to shit.
Swear to shit.
No, I'm not even... I'm not
you
even,
swear to shit.
I swear
don't
on the Sex Pistols, mate.
Don't
I
throw
swear,
that around lightly.
I'll swear on the Sex Pistols. I'll swear on Oasis. I'll swear on the Clash. I'll swear on anything you want,
swear
mate.
On Gwar.
Okay, I'll swear on guar, mate.
Guar?
Yeah.
Are we talking about the same thing?
Yeah.
Guar?
Yeah.
We're talking about the same thing, right?
Yeah, the alien band. Yeah, I know the
I like
fucking.
how that pulled you out of your
I
accent.
know, right? I know who fucking. I showed you
I
who
know.
guar is,
I
Dustin.
said gua and I didn't know if you were gonna
Guar!
I didn't know if you were gonna understand. Run us through. What are their names?
God damn
What is
it.
him? What is he? I was, what is him?
What is he?
What
Well,
is
so
him? That's what I just said.
I did make two tanks. So I made a Warden tank, which I think are pretty
Oh, I
cool.
got the chills.
And
Sorry.
they use a lot of like the ice abilities or whatever,
I
or
got the
whatever,
chills
right?
right there.
You got
Ice
the
abilities, and I
chills?
got the chills.
Oh man. So immediately when I think of like ice and like wardens and stuff, literally I think of fucking Arnold Schwarzenegger's Mr. Freeze in Batman
Oh my
Forever.
God.
All of his fucking horrible, horrible puns, dude. So I didn't name him after one of the puns in the movie because they're just none of them are good enough to like, or like, I just don't know what one of his lines
They're
would do
funny
well.
because they're so bad,
So
but
I
they don't
named
really
him,
apply.
yeah, well, I named him one after an episode. It's an episode of The Simpsons that's like making fun of villains doing those. So his name is Ice to See You.
So fucking dumb, dude. It's so stupid.
Yeah, his name is Ice to See You. He's an Argonian.
He's a
And
warden.
he's a warden. A warden Argonian. He's a tickety tank.
Ice to
And
see
yeah,
you.
he's like, I haven't really played him that much, to be honest with
I
you.
know,
Just
because
a
he's
little bit.
addicted to creating
Well,
characters,
and then I
finding
made
the
a.
funny name, and then he messages me the funny name, and then I'm like, oh, hey, that's cool. And then I never see them again.
Yep, that happens sometimes for sure.
Sometimes?
Well, it's like, well, not all the time, because my healer, it's not really a funny name, but it's a. I named him after a character in Remember the Titans.
Sunshine.
Sunshine! Well, because I thought it was funny because he's a Templar and he's like
Oh, you
all
wanted me to make a tank and name
sunshine.
him Gary Bertier.
No. I wanted us both to make tanks.
Oh,
So this
yeah.
is what we
Okay.
should we haven't done it yet. We need to. So I want us to both make tanks, and then I want you to
I'll
be,
be left
yeah,
side
you be left
and
side
he'll be strong
and I'll be
side.
strong side. Yeah. Left side. I
Strong
fucking
side.
love that movie, dude. It's
It's
such
a
a good movie.
great
That's such a good
movie.
movie. But then, like, what's the only time that you would use two tanks in what, fucking trials?
Trials.
Yeah, but.
PvP maybe.
Oh, yeah,
Alliance
I
War.
guess. But.
But not really that important, really.
Yeah.
Not really that important, really. That's the sentence
And
that
then
just
I
came out
made
of my mouth.
a Dragon Knight. A Dragon Knight tank.
The DK.
Yeah, which has
Donkey
been really
Kong.
fun playing. He's like level 20. I've got him pretty far already. I named. He's an orc. Because I like being in the old Daggerfall Covenant. So he's an orc, and I named him Chug Mug. Chug Mug.
Yeah,
Because I thought it
so
sounded like an orc name, but then it's like he's because he's drunk. Because he's chugging the mug. He's a mug chugger. Chug Mug.
the funny thing is, he didn't even know this. His orc tank is named Chugmug. My orc tank is named Frogmog. So we're Chugmug and Frogmog and left-sided Chugmug and
I didn't even
Frogmog.
like think that those names would. I like because I thought of Chug Mug and thought it was fucking funny. Because I literally
Mine
like
just
was
so
thinking
happened to be
while I was going
Frogmog.
through like you know those like little name generators or whatever. I was looking at the orc for Skyrim ones, and then I didn't see Chug Mug in there or whatever, right? But I thought because all of them were like Ugrog, Ulog, Bogajrog or whatever the fuck. You know what I mean? Like
What
all
the
that's like all
fuck?
the orc sounds or whatever, right? That. I
All
don't
the
fucking
orc
know.
sounds?
That's how all their names sound, or like, you know what I mean? So then I thought Chug was funny. So then I was like, Chug Mug. I don't know. I just thought of it, but like, I thought it was funny. But then yeah, you told me you were like, dude, that literally sounds like my fucking
Frogmog.
Chug Mug and Frog Mug.
If only mine was Frogmug.
Frog
Chugmug
Mug.
and Frogmug,
Jesus
the
Christ.
brothers, the twins.
Right. Okay. And then I did my first trial this week too.
I created a new character.
Oh yeah, who is your new character, Dusty?
He's a red guard.
A red
He's a
guard.
dragon knight. Okay.
Oh yeah, I forgot. What's your red guard's name, Dusty?
My red guard's name is Kendrick Llama.
Literally cannot believe that that wasn't fucking taken.
I know, I didn't have to do any funky letters or
Kendrick
anything.
Llama. But then I like, how many nerds listen to fucking Kendrick Lamar? How many people that play ESO listen to Kendrick? Let us know in the comments.
Do
How
you listen to Kendrick
many
Lamar?
of you ESO playing nerds
Like us.
listen to fucking Kendrick Lamar?
You know, the bright side for them is They don't do a podcast about it. Like, we're that, we're so nerdy to the point where we
super, super nerds.
Where we were like, let's do a podcast.
We are absolutely mega nerds, dude.
Everyone, if you're a mega nerd, start a podcast. Save your life.
Save a life. Talk about it to other nerds. So I did my first trial, the Maw of Lorikaj, which I was reading about it online. It says that it's the hardest one. I don't know. We just did it on normal, and I was fucking DPS, so I like just fucking did my rotation and like
didn't really do much.
But it was honestly, it was fucking crazy, dude. Like some of the shit that they do in these trials, like it was so fucking cool. All of the boss mechanics, because like we went in, there was like a little boss or whatever at the beginning, and then you go into this room where, and the chick that was like leading us through it or whatever, she said, I guess a lot of groups get held up on the twins, is what they call them. So these two big ass Khajiits, dude. And it's like, they're fucking huge. Like they're big ass Khajiits and they have these big two handers.
Like,
and they both like have.
Like Peter Dinklage from the Avengers movie?
Yeah.
The dwarf
that's well, not quite that big, but they're big ass Khajiit. But they like, it's hard because I've only done it once, so I'm probably explaining it horribly wrong. But like each of the Khajiits have like a dark aura around their head, and then the other one has a light aura around their head, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of like split up into two teams, and then you'll get a light aura if you're fighting the light Khajiit, and then the dark Khajiit, you'll get a dark aura, right? And then mm-hmm. like some shit happens and you'll either have to rotate, the tanks have to rotate a couple times.
Ooh,
or
that's
and get this, dude, if you fucking run into someone, if you touch someone that's on the other team, you both die.
What the fuck?
Yeah, it's like the fucking kookiest, like it's crazy. That's I thought a weird it was ass so mechanic funny.
But that's really interesting.
I thought it was so funny. That's funny. And then the final boss is like this big fucking Daedric looking dude, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
did you happen to catch his name?
I can't remember.
They always have cool names.
Yeah, I can't remember. Yeah, but so you have to do like a little run. So there's like all these different pads that the tank would have to stand on to get a certain buff, and then we would all have to be DPSing and getting healed and shit. And then someone had to go into a different room, and then they would have to run across these. It was like this big like fucking loop-de-loop thing, and they mm-hmm. had to jump across these big chasms and shit. And yeah, it was fucking crazy. And you'd have to like hit all the synergies in a certain order. And like
oh it's fucking God.
Crazy. Like
that's
the,
crazy.
It's nuts, dude. Like when we How walked into that room, it's 12 trials? For trials. 12? It's 12. Okay. Yeah. So we had one of the DPS do it. But like we went in there and the chick was like, anyone who's DPS should know how to do this. So I wasn't the one that volunteered to
Cody's
do it.
Cody's in the back just like.
Well, she asked. It was actually kind of funny because she was like, all right, who wants to do it? Because she's clearly like, she was going to tank, but then we couldn't find another healer. So she switched to her other healer. So like, because obviously people that know that lead are typically healing or tanking.
Support classes.
Yeah, for the most part. Really, it's mostly the tanks that do it. And then the healers are like the fucking lieutenants, essentially.
Mm-hmm.
But like, so typically it's DPS that does shit like that. We'll do like yeah. little runs or whatever.
I feel like
but so
feel
she
like...
showed us all how to do it. And like, it's kind of, it's fucking cool, dude. Like, and we would be going and she'd like, go runners, go. And then it's like a certain animation that the boss would do that would let you know that you have to go do the run. Like,
that's fucking crazy.
Honestly, it was super, super fun. It took us like 45 minutes. Like, it was way cool. We just did it on normal, so like I guess because we had so much DPS, we would kill them before they did the other mechanics that they were supposed to do. But like,
yeah, and Cody dropped so everything cool. to play this trial.
Yeah, dude, I wanted to fucking do it, dude.
We were having a nice conversation about what we were going to talk about
today. I had started the trial before.
No, you're like, oh, I'm doing a travel by a
I'm
travel
doing a trial
a travel.
All right, let's get into our main topic for the day.
The meat of the episode.
So we're going to do just a slight little beginner's guide type of thing, just kind of super casual. Yeah. I've just hit level 50 on my second character. Dusty just hit level 50 on his first. So
basically, we're experts.
So we've just, so. Yeah, basically, we literally, ZeniMax Online, if you're looking for employees, hello. I'd like to do all of your protesting and stuff like that. So, because I'm super
can I be
expert.
A moderator on your forum? Because
yeah,
I know everything.
I literally know everything about the game.
Why do we keep
literally? Literally, I know everything.
I know everything.
So, first thing I wanted to talk about was choosing your race and class, and like
does not
alliance.
Seem like a big deal at face value. I think where it really gets to the point where you. Really, like, I guess not need to know what you're doing, but the most important part about choosing your race, especially your race, is the passives you get. The early game bonuses, whatever
sure.
the bonuses, don't really matter. It's the passives you get for your racials. Your racial passages. That sounds weird saying
You
it.
said passages, not passives. That's why it sounded weird.
Racial passives.
Yeah, it's the passives they give you.
Yeah.
Really, for me, it's just all about choosing something, choosing a class and something you want to do that kind of goes along with your race. Is that what I was
yeah.
saying? Yeah. Choosing
Honestly,
a class that
like...
goes along with those passives. So, like, if you're a Red Guard, they have really good stamina passives, so you're probably going to want to go. Not that you have to.
No.
Because those passives are just good. You can honestly, unless you're, like, 100% min-maxing, you can definitely do a fucking Breton, like, stamina
yeah, dude,
if
you
really
can,
wanted to.
Honestly, the class system and the skill lines are so versatile, you can literally do any race, any class, any build, essentially, that you really, like.
Yeah, you really
desires.
Could.
Honestly,
like, you wouldn't be the absolute best stamina character fucking ever, but, like,
no.
You'd be fine.
Honestly, like, I heard this a lot playing other games, especially Overwatch, is when you're first starting, being good isn't that important. Just have fun. Find what's fun. If you want to be a Magicka character, make a sorcerer. If you want to be a sword, dual-wield, sneaky bow and arrow boy, be a sneaky bow and arrow boy. Like, just play what you think is going to be fun.
Well, and that's
after
like,
you get a certain amount of game knowledge and game sense, you can start to, like, I kind of want to get good, put some more time into this game.
Yeah.
Then you can
Well, and I
build.
Think that goes along the lines of, like, why I think ESO is so cool with how versatile, like, some of the things that you can do are the builds you can make or whatever, because, like, you wouldn't think, looking at a Nightblade, that a Magicka Nightblade, you'd think, like, what, a fucking wizard sneaky dude? Like,
a
what the fuck?
Sneaky wizard boy.
But they are so fucking good.
Mm-hmm.
The Magicka Nightblades are fucking way good right now.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, like, or stamina.
And you can create a lot of characters. Honestly, just fucking, like, toy around with a bunch of different classes and just, like, well, that ability was cool. I like that about Nightblades. And then maybe play your sorcerer and be like,
or, like,
oh, shit.
I like asking people,
Wall
too.
Of Elements. That
I
was
like.
Dope.
I like asking people too, especially in like dungeons and shit, when they do like an attack that I think looks cool or something, or does a shitload of damage, or like is a big healer or something. I'll ask them like, "Yo, what the fuck is that?"
Yeah,
that was dope.
Honestly, educating yourself too, watching YouTube videos, listening to podcasts.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah, just the more game knowledge. The more game knowledge you have, I think the more fun you're gonna have. But beginning, dude, just build anything. Just go crazy.
It's all about having fun, man, because you'll learn as you go.
Yeah,
you'll learn as you go.
That's the easiest thing. Way to learn is to play the game.
Just fucking play. That's like
play, dude.
It's one of those things that, like, do you remember that Lord of the Rings game on the fucking PS2 that we used to play all the time?
Oh my god, yes.
You know how, like, you I don't know what it is about that game that I loved, like, finding out the combos by accident, and then, like, because, you know, you can go into the
well,
menu
it's kind of like those
the combos,
Street
like,
Fighter kind of games where you, like, you're just kind of fucking around, and then you find that one combo, and you're like, oh
yeah,
shit,
you're like, what the fuck was that that I
or
just
like
did?
Super Smash Bros. When you hit that combo, and you're just like, oh, hello, dear,
I just killed him.
I knocked him off the map with
oh,
that one.
Shit. Yeah, it's really cool. But really, the biggest thing I'll look for is, like, because obviously for certain builds, there is a race that's going to be slightly better
yeah.
for anything. But really,
sure.
do it whatever. If your friends all play in the Daggerfall Covenant and you want to make something Magicka-based, do a fucking Breton. If you want to do an Orc or a fucking Red Guard, do whatever you want, man.
And if you, like, make a mistake, level 43, you get a free respec.
Yeah, and if you make a mistake and accidentally join the Ebonheart Pact, then
start a new character.
Just start a new character. just start a new character.
Jesus. All hail the Daggerfall Covenant, baby.
Or the Aldmeri. I'm fine with the Aldmeri Dominion just because I like
Daggerfall
the elves,
all the way.
But fucking...
For the Horde.
The
I mean
orcs,
Daggerfall Covenant.
Orcs, yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Dusty, fuck!
God.
Dusty,
we have to start over.
That's the wrong game, Dusty. Fuck. But the next part, and honestly, this is the most important.
This, dude, I'm not even kidding. This is no funny business. The most important part about creating a new
there are three,
character.
And there are three types of them.
There's
is naming.
Your funny names.
You got the funny, the joke names.
Just a funny ass name. Like my main is, his name is, excuse me, brother. It's just kind of funny.
It's just kind of funny. It's a little weird.
It's just what it is.
What?
Excuse me, brother?
And then there's the pun names.
Ice to
important.
See you.
Ice to see you. Kendrick Llama.
That's more of just a funny one. That's not really a pun. Kendrick Lamar.
That's definitely a pun. His last name is Lamar.
Kendrick Lamar. Okay.
Yeah, it's a fucking pun. That's a pun, Dusty.
What do I know?
That's nothing, literally what apparently. A pun is.
Why am I even
and
on this
three,
podcast?
And three.
I just get all sad.
Just fucking walk off. And three is like a role play name. So like I like doing that too because I like getting into like especially with like I don't know what it is about wood elves, but fucking wood elves make me want to just like,
I usually do that.
Go sit in the forest with, and like
with elvish names. Elven names. With elf characters. I like having I don't know, their names
like
are
an
just elfy cool.
sounding name or
something. I did that a lot more in Skyrim and Oblivion. Yeah, so like I just think it's kind of funny. Like, if you ever hover over somebody's name and it's something funny, I'm like,
yeah, I love like scrolling over someone's name and it's funny. So funny.
Or like I see their name in chat and I'm just like, what? That's kind of funny. But
I did make I did make a Red Guard. I totally forgot about this. I made three new characters, but I don't know that I'm gonna ever play it because I wanted to make a stamina sorcerer. Because I thought it'd be fucking weird and cool if I don't know if they're
see,
good.
See, welcome to ESO.
Yeah, then like I thought it'd be like I don't know. I like read a thing about it online and was like, oh, that seems like it'd be kind of cool. So a stamina sorcerer. So yeah, I made a sorcerer that's a Red Guard, sneezed. And I named him Samuel L. Jaxiwoff.
Jesus Christ. Somebody get him some help.
Might get banned for that one, but we'll see how long I can last on. I don't know what happens if they just
well, is
like,
it me off or you off?
No, it's you off. Jax you off.
Well, maybe that's a good thing for them, so.
I'm handing them out. If you ever see me come in ESO playing Samuel Jax you off, I will jack you off.
This is my podcast co-host.
Oh,
we are
God.
Co-hosts, and he's one of them.
Yeah. Well, there's naming is very important. And then we wanted to talk about the importance of doing the main story quests. And I think it's not just the main story quests because you get good gear, you get the skill points. It's a lot of other quests will do that too. Like if you go do the Dark Brotherhood main story, you get skill points for that. If you go do the Thieves Guild main story, you get points for that. You get skill points for that. If you go do the, I'm sure if you go do the Hrothgar main story, you get skill points for that. Just doing those quest lines that
the
will
big main
get
stories.
You. Yeah, the big main stories, you'll get the skill points.
My favorite part about the profit reward specifically is, I can't remember if it's everyone or just a lot of them. The gear you get has the training ability. So
yeah,
you'll
get
extra experience for every kill you get. So in the beginning,
so yeah,
training
if
gear
you don't
is the
have,
best gear to have.
If you don't have a guild or you don't have anyone that can make you training gear, then it makes the main quest even more important because you can get the training gear that you need to make sure
the
you're
the hard
leveling.
Part about these kind of quests is you can't just binge it. Like, you
well,
get the new quest every certain level. Dark Brotherhood is daily. So it's not like
you
can just
it.
Grind it
well,
over
no, you
and
can.
Over and over.
You just gotta, like, do the dailies along with it. But the dailies will stack up, though, if you don't
that's
do them.
More pertaining to the Prophet than the Dark Brotherhood. Is like it's
the
at a
profit's
certain
based
level.
Off of a level. The Dark Brotherhood, you just have to do is those contracts.
If you happen to level with the Prophet's story just so perfectly that you can do them one right after another, you're in luck. But when I know when I started, I only
or if you
wanted
just wait
to do the Prophet
the
quest.
End.
Yeah, I only wanted to do the Prophet quest. I was really into the main story for some reason. It was like a new
it's
story.
It's a good story.
To me. Yeah,
it's a good story.
But I wasn't leveling fast enough to like just keep doing it over and over and over.
It's better
so
than
I
Skyrim's
had to, like,
main story.
Skyrim beat Oblivion in our episode, so fucking suck it.
Okay, that doesn't mean it has a better story. So yeah, the main story is good. The next thing I wanted to talk about was, and we kind of touched on it a little bit, was about getting into a guild early on.
Mm-hmm.
And we can talk about the ESO community along with that. It's just like people are really nice. Getting into a guild is really good because
people are really nice is an understatement.
Because you can have someone. Well, I know you wanted to talk about that thing that happened.
Oh
this
my
week.
God, that
we
was so funny.
That. But so with guilds, I would just join one, join whatever you can. People will post a little blurb in zone chats a lot, especially around like Daggerfall, Auradon, Grotwood, the big like gathering places. People will drop them in there. Or you can look on ESO forums because I've joined like a big ass trading guild That's really good. Or like I joined a streamer's guild that I really like. I joined his guild and then other stuff. Like you can find them on there. Those ones are a little bit kind of harder to get into, especially the trading guilds. I have to like sell a certain amount of things, or I have to put, if I don't sell stuff, I have to put gold into the guild bank to like, or whatever. That's like, which is fine. I don't mind.
It's not that bad.
Yeah. Once well, and you get I a usually, certain amount of gold. Well, and like I get enough motifs from doing like the Dark Brotherhood stuff and other stuff that like I can usually sell enough anyway, but like, but yeah, I think being in a guild is really good for getting advice from other players and getting training gear from some, from a crafter that can train, get all that training stuff for you.
Just hit them up in the chats.
But even if you don't, the ESO community in general, like straight up, if you just have a question, fucking put it in zone chat and literally
slash zone, dude.
And all your questions
will be answered.
Yeah.
Dude. So yeah, that story, Cody mentioned, dude. So I'm obviously not like a very, very new player to the game, but I guess I'm relatively new. But it was just funny because it was right as I just started Kendrick Llama, my new red guard.
And so you're like level three.
I was like level three, and I accidentally hit a guard because I was trying my new abilities, and I didn't have any gold to pay off my bounty, so my bounty just kept getting bigger, and they just kept attacking me. And so I finally make it to the Way Shrine after being killed like, and I just reset at the Way Shrine. I get there, I'm walking like every 10 feet, I'm just getting it caught by another guard, and I just let him kill me. Then I revive, nope, dead again. And this guy saw what was happening. I know he saw that I was like level three. My character was like level three. Yeah. And he just whispers to me, he's like, hey man, guards are actually invincible, so you can't kill them. And I was just like,
well, they're not invincible, but they have okay, like 10 they have million, 10 million health. Yeah, so they're pretty much, yeah.
Like, and I was just like, what a nice dude. Like, he like, literally hey, went so out of know. His way to like help a new player. So, I mean, all the communities like that.
Yeah.
Like, well, a lot I think of people funny. Will go out of their way to help you.
I think it's funny just because that's kind of a thing in like Oblivion and Skyrim when you're bored. What do? Massacre a town.
I don't know, dude. Fucking shoot an arrow at this guard. Fuck it.
So I'm just going to run around and kill all the high elves.
That's what I do when I haven't played Skyrim in like 2 months. I'll just go back on an old character and just fuck with people.
Yeah.
Just kill just everything.
Kill a bunch of shit. Yeah, so true.
Yeah.
And then I wanted to talk about the best way to level versus the fastest way to level. So in my personal opinion,
you talk more about this. I've only leveled one character. So
well, I've leveled, I have a couple that are like right around 30 and 20, right around that. I'm kind of like leveling on the side as I'm doing the top end content with my DPS and my healer.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I leveled two characters. One of them I leveled way, 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 way fast during the last year's Jester's Festival.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, last year's Jester's Festival. And so I had that 100 or 150, I think it's 100% XP boost. And then I purchased some Psijic Ambrosia.
Oh, I got the chills again.
The 150%. So I had a 250% XP scroll. I had all training gear. And I had a Ring of Mara with you, but you didn't play with me as much as I wanted you to. So I didn't really have that for a lot, but that's okay.
I was on a kick with another game.
And I literally almost exclusively just grinded fucking dolmens in the Alakir desert, which is boring as fuck, but I literally just like, I have two screens on my PC set up, so I literally just put on like The Office on like one thing, and then I'd be grinding dolmens and like office dolmen office dolmen and just like listening, because I've watched The Office a million fucking times, so just like looking back and forth and like, oh, this is happening.
Honestly,
then,
like, dude, who hasn't, like, yeah, Office. If you haven't watched The Office at least four times, amazing. We can't be friends.
It's amazing. But just so kidding. What ended up happening is I got to the end, I hit level 50, and I just kind of like, oh sick, right? But I only used
oh,
like
sick
oh cool fuck. Now what do I do? So what I found out is I number one, didn't join the Fighters Guild.
Yeah, so
didn't
that kind
of join the Mages Guild. The Mages Guild not so important for the Nightblade thing I'm working off of. It might eventually, because I looking around, a lot of Nightblades use the Mages Guild ult, and I am a level like one Mages Guild.
I know. Nightblade. I'm like a CP50, and I'm 9.5 in the Mages Guild.
It's like takes a while.
It takes forever. I've been consistently doing lore books since I started that character, and I still
it's
don't
like,
have 10.
It's got to be like 500 lore books or it's some like, shit that you've got to get, or 200 or something.
I can't remember how many are in the game, but it's like 70% of
you have to get
what's
a lot
in
of
the
them.
Game. Yeah.
But anyway, so I got to the end. I didn't have the Fighters Guild shit. And if you play ESO a lot and you play Nightblades or stamina characters, you know that the Fighters Guild is pretty goddamn important for
I
stuff like
remember,
that.
dude, I was actually, we were on a Discord chat or a call
Yeah.
when you realized you didn't have the Fighters Guild, and Cody was just like, it went quiet, and he was just like, fuck, I need the Fighters Guild.
And I
'Cause
literally had to grind
it
again.
was
Like, I was
so
just like,
funny.
motherfucker. Like, I got
You would have had 10
all this
Fighters
way
Guild by like level 30 if
easy.
you started at
Because I was
one.
grinding dolmens and killing Daedra, which would raise your raises your Fighter's Guild level. Doing dolmens raises it.
Which kind of puts us into our next point here. Skill trees early on.
Well, let's talk about the other stuff first. But yeah, so the best way to so the point I'm getting to is the
Oh.
fastest way to level can be really good if you know what you're doing. And you know the build you're going for. If you're like an experienced player, I think fast leveling is fine. Because I've seen videos of people doing it in like fucking 8 hours hitting level
Oh,
50
God.
of just mindless, mind-numbing grinding. But
I couldn't do
I
that
couldn't
for
do
eight
that.
hours.
8 hours is a long time to do that shit. But still, that's like if you really are like, oh, I want to play a Magblade and I want to make sure I can do it during the Mid-Year Mayhem event, what the fuck am I gonna do? I'm level one. Then maybe fast leveling is what you got to do if you're an experienced player already, and that's fine. But I think the best way to level, honestly, and this is how I've been leveling my tank that I'm leveling right now, because sky shards are important, especially if you're crafting. Like, because on my main, like, Nightblade is my main, like, crafting character, and you seriously need like fucking 70
You need a lot.
skill points for if you want to be good at. Because I'm like crafting on everything. Like, I want that to be like a master crafter, essentially. And you seriously, you need a shitload of skill points for
Yeah.
that. So, like,
Sky shards aren't too hard to farm either.
no, you just need to walk around. And, like, so what I'm getting to, the best way I've been leveling right now, and especially for lore books too, I've just been picking a zone and then doing everything in that zone.
Well, what I really like
And
to
just
do.
running around, and I'll do a delve real quick and go through there and kill everything and kill the boss. And there's usually like a sky shard or a lore book or something in there. And then I'll go out and then I'll run around to the next lore book. And then I'll go hit the next sky shard and I'll kill everything as I'm going. And I'll pick up every single resource thing as I'm going. And I'll just like clear out an entire zone. And then I'll hit the next zone. And then what I think that's good too is once you hit 50, not only will you have probably Mage's Guild 10. Probably Fighters Guild 10.
You won't have
Probably,
Mage's Guild 10.
well, High Mage's Guild or whatever.
Nine and a half,
But you'll
baby.
probably have Fighters Guild 10. You'll probably have a
Oh, if you do
fuckload of skill
Dolmens, you'll have
points.
Fighter's Guild 10 so easy.
Yeah, well, it takes a while, but still, it's
So
like.
easy. Super easy.
Okay. But anyway, but then you'll. I'm still not even Fighters Guild 10 on my main. I'm like Fighters
Well,
Guild
that's because
9.
you started late.
I'm almost 10 now, but fucking so annoying. I just want flawless Dawnbreaker, Dusty. I just want the ult.
Here's what I really. Oh, wait, yeah, you finish.
But you'll have a shitload of skill points. You'll have the skill things you want to go. You'll all the skill lines that you want to use or
Respec if you
whatever.
need it.
Respec if you need it, but like, yeah, go through. Another thing I realized too is I only had like 12 abilities that I was using on my front and back bar. So like when I was looking at builds and other moves and other active abilities that I wanted to do, I had no experience on them, so I had to use them to be able to use the morph that was recommended or like whatever you wanted to use. So like, I don't know. It's just like I said, fast leveling is good, but the best way I think to level is just running around and doing shit and getting sky shards and lore books and killing everything in your path, picking up all the resources in your path, and just like, and you can sell those resources off too if like you're wanting to do gold and make sure you have money along the time. Crafting mats sell for a lot, so you can sell those.
I have two leveling cycles real quick. My first leveling cycle, I queue for a dungeon, and because I play a DPS, it takes a minute.
Just run around and
Takes about
do.
10 minutes. I either lore book hunt and sky shard hunt in between my queues for dungeons, because honestly, dungeons are probably my favorite part in ESO.
Yeah.
Like, it's the most fun to me. Yeah, so I either sky shard, lore book hunt, do delves, and then my other one is I'll queue for a dungeon, and then I'll pop an experience scroll, and then I'll do dolmens, and that time. Once I get into the dungeon, I've already got an experience scroll going.
Right.
I can just keep it. Then, right as I'm done with the dungeon, I get out. I'm already in the dolmen rotation. So,
Right.
you just get in these cycles where You get the exact skill lines you want. It's perfect.
Yeah,
Get in
it's
the
really good.
cycles, find the
Another thing
rhythm.
I think is good too is if you do that where you're clearing a zone and then you go and clear another zone, then you're gonna have all those fucking way shrines for later
True
on when
as
you like
fuck. You're
when
gonna
you
have
like
so many way shrines,
for you
dude.
like when you want to go do something, and that gains you
You get a little XP
XP, I think,
whenever you
too.
discover a new location.
Yeah, so I think that's good. And yeah, that leads into my next thing, which is making sure you get the right skill trees early on. The first thing you should be doing is going to the Mages Guild and going to the Fighters Guild and making sure you've got all that
Honestly, it's
shit.
not even specific to your build. Just join all the guilds.
Yeah.
Join all of them.
When you hit
Fuck it.
45, go make sure you join the Undaunted so you can start
Yeah.
getting the Undaunted
Fuck it, dude. Join all
leveled
of them.
up
That
and
way, if you find a build you like, once you have a little bit more game knowledge, you have the ability to kind of do whatever you want.
exactly. Psijic Order, now that Somerset's out,
Dude,
go join the
everybody is using
Psijics.
Psijic Order. Every recent build I've seen, Psijic
Every
Order. Every
because
single,
some of
no
the
matter what. It's the ultimate.
well like
It's that stun ultimate
the
for
ultimate's
PvP.
really good for PvP, the stuns are really good for PvP, the like one of the passives if you have a one of the passives is like if you have a Psijic Order slotted, a Psijic Order thing slotted, then when you block, you get a damage bubble. That like there, which is great for tanks and great for really anything. Like
It's a
it's
very
so fucking good.
versatile skill
It's
line.
such a good skill line. Yeah, so level that one too. And then leveling skills versus passives. We were talking about this a little bit earlier, Dusty. Passives are fucking amazing. They're so good.
Passives are very important to how the game will, I guess, play for you, not
Well,
how
it
you
like,
play the game.
well,
But
the
it,
passives
yeah.
are like giving you extra bonuses. So it's like, oh, if you have this many abilities slotted, then you get this boost to your max magicka or
Well,
like whatever, like stuff like that.
this thing, especially about ESO, took me longer than I'm proud to say to realize that, like, a 1.5% increase is, like, huge. Like, it took me a long time to realize that, like, that's for a
Shit adds
passive,
up, man.
that's
Shit
huge. Because
adds
it, and
up.
then it's like, when you look and it's like, for every piece of light armor you have, you get max magicka added. And it's like, your current bonus is like 4,000. And I was like, oh,
Shit adds up, man. It adds
goddamn.
up. Passives are good, but they are not good when you're leveling because they don't do anything.
No,
They're
no,
good
no.
for your, like, if you're like, I don't know, like, I just don't think.
You have to use your active abilities in order to level the skill line to max level, because every
So,
skill line is either 10 or 50 for the max level,
yeah, but
or the guild
I mean
lines are 10.
leveling, the active skills so you can morph them. So what I'll
Well, yeah,
do, what
yeah.
I've been doing with my Dragon Knight tank that I've been leveling up is I've been literally just cycling. Every time I get a new move, I'll spend the skill point on it, slot it on my bar, see what it does, and it's cool to learn all the abilities too and
Game
see what the
knowledge.
fuck it does.
Game knowledge.
So, but not only that, it also levels it up so that way when I hit level 50, I have all of the skills already leveled to where I can morph them. So if I ever need to switch around, I've got them all ready to morph.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's just good to build yourself for success, essentially.
And honestly, I think it's pretty clear the best way to level is gonna take a lot longer than the fastest. But honestly, for me, character creation and leveling is my favorite part of the game.
Well, like,
Dungeons are my favorite part to play.
number one, you can do it by yourself. You can do quests along the way. So I would absolutely suggest going in. If you are a Dark Brotherhood fiend like we are, then go to the fucking Dark Brotherhood DLC if you can access it.
ESO
Do the
Plus.
Dark Brotherhood skill lines. Do the fucking. And along the way, grab the Sky Shards. Grab every lore book. Grab every crafting thing you see. Just grab along the way. Make sure you're doing this. Do the Prophet quests. Do the. It's like, honestly, it's such a cool game and all the storylines and stuff that you can do that. And then if your buddy gets on or people on your guild get on and they're on the same level as you, you can like, oh, hey, let's go do a dungeon. Let's
Yeah.
go do a public dungeon.
And you don't
Do you
even
guys
have
want
to
to
be
run
the
around
same
with me?
level.
Let's go do something.
You could
Yeah.
be level 10 and he could be CP 1200.
Well,
Do a dungeon together. It doesn't
as
matter.
long as it's a dungeon that he can do. But yeah, it's, you know,
When you're in a
like
group,
as long as you're level
it only
10.
can queue you for this certain dungeon.
Well, yeah, as long as you're level 10, you can go do the fucking
Whatever it is.
whatever the lowest one is. I
I don't
can't remember
know.
what it is. It's the one that I got the
Craghorn
it's the Crags. It's the one
or
that I got the
Crags.
Crags set
Ow.
in. I can't
Charmed
remember what it's
Horse.
called. But yeah, you can go do that dungeon, or you can run around and do the delves. The delves you might fucking clean too hard if you're in a group, but go do a public dungeon, or like, you know, there's
Queue for a
like
regular dungeon.
Yeah, there's like, I don't know, there's honestly, so much cool stuff around.
Like, I heard a Twitch streamer say this a few weeks ago. There's over 3,000 hours of content in Elder Scrolls Online.
Honestly, I think that's probably downplaying it.
I think that was before Somerset came out. So
3,000 is, I feel like, not that much still, for an MMO.
Still, that's there's so much shit you can do. That's my favorite part about, like, just Elder Scrolls Online, because Elder Scrolls, like just the regular games, I've played them, the two big ones, Oblivion and Skyrim, like we've both played and viewed. I've viewed more than you, obviously, but we've gone through those so many times doing pretty much everything. I feel like I can safely say I've done 98% of the quests in Skyrim.
For sure.
So, like, having this whole new Elder Scrolls universe, and dude, it's the same thing with, like, Pokemon. Like, okay, hear me out. It's the same thing with Pokemon, right? Every Elder Scroll player's dream is to go everywhere in Tamriel. Every Pokemon player's dream is to go to every region.
Right.
Right? And so this game provides that outlet to where I can go everywhere that they have out in Tamriel.
Which it's just like...
like, it's so much fun. Just exploring, just walking around is so much fun to me.
Walking around in Somerset and fighting the weird, like... Daedric shit that's coming out, or going to fucking Skyrim, you fight
fucking
and
Minotaurs,
going, going to the Rift,
and like, yeah, dude, it's awesome.
Yeah, like,
and seeing it's cool seeing how Skyrim in ESO compared to the actual Skyrim game, like it.
Well, because ESO is in the second era before
this
Talos,
is 1,000 years or so before.
Yeah, because it's ESO is before Talos.
Yeah, so it's cool to see pre-Skyrim Skyrim. Pre-Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim.
Yeah, that sounds good.
I said yeah. Okay.
So we talked about that. Then we wanted to talk about builds a little bit. Actual, like, official builds from people. Yeah. They are good. I personally don't go straight off of them. One, because I really like kind of doing that stuff myself.
Mm-hmm.
And for, like, I'll definitely read them.
It's kind of
to
that
see.
Pride builder. Like, I built this dope-ass character by myself.
Well, yeah, I think that's good. But I also think, like, they are really good to look at. This is the same thing, like, I haven't said this yet, but I play Magic the Gathering all the time. It's the same thing as, like, looking at someone else's deck list that's like, yeah, that's really good, but I don't want to just play exactly your fucking deck list. You know, I don't want to play
your own little zany
I don't
want to
play exactly some guy's build that I look up, like the big build guys like Deltia's Gaming and Alcast and and guys like that, that like they're amazing builds and they probably are the fucking best skill builds in the game.
Yeah.
But like, or like Kevduit's builds or whatever, like they're so good, but like I want to make my own build, you know? Like,
honestly,
I want to make, and I would go off of that to like, if you're curious about what sets are good or like what skill lines are really good for your kind of character that you're building or whatever, then I think, yeah, absolutely you should look at them. And if you want to go straight off of that, then there's no shame in that. Go for it. They're probably the
if you go off of a build to the T, you're gonna have a better set than we do.
You're like, gonna have a fucking amazing character because
they are
sure.
Very good builds that they put out. Like
they really
maximum 100% best stats you could get from
that like,
build. Like it's
do that shit for a living, gaming and shit, which
yeah,
like
dude,
would
it's
be
insane.
So awesome. But yeah, it's like
one could wish.
It's well, no, it's like
it goes back to the same thing. Like. I said before, just fucking have fun. If it's fun for you to go off a build, have fun doing it. If it's fun for you to create your own character and just go with whatever the hell you want, fucking go with whatever the hell
well,
you want.
Well,
keep
just in mind
fun.
Too, when you look at those, like that is top tier ass gear that they put
yeah,
out.
And leveling.
Even the beginner's gear is like the fucking 8-9 set craftable gear. Like it's still gear that's not super
once
expensive to get
yeah.
a hold of, but like it's still pretty.
And you gotta have a few max level characters to where you can even access
or
that
craft
kind of
at all, or
crafting
or
materials,
go grind.
Like,
you know,
yeah.
like the Alkosh set that's like super popular right now from Mob Lorkaj. That's like, well, hope you have a group to play trials a shitload in because you gotta go grind Mob Lorkaj to get that to get those drops.
Dude.
So hope you have good RNG and you get that fucking ring that you want. Yeah, that's like, and it takes
a lot
of time.
And then when you don't get it first try, and you gotta do it again. Like,
fuck.
God.
Yeah.
Darn it.
So yeah, builds are good. Next thing I want to talk about is crafting. So if you want to be a crafter,
a lot of people do.
So
That's
I personally really like crafting.
I
liked it in WoW. I like it in any fucking game. I like it in Skyrim. I like it in Oblivion. I like crafting my own gear.
Here's my thing. Haven't ESO hasn't hooked me in crafting yet. Skyrim and Oblivion, that's all I ever wanted to do. That's for some reason, Elder Scrolls Online just hasn't gotten to me yet.
So as far as one crafting. Thing I would and suggest to you. And I think that's
because I don't have enough time in the game yet.
Yeah, one thing I would suggest to you, though, Dusty, is to start researching traits on a character that you are okay with being your crafting character, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Because the traits take fucking forever.
I have one all instant research.
Yes, but that will only do it for a day. Those ones that you get from like leveling up, like it'll only do it for a day. So like needs to be, if you want to be a crafter, the second you decide you want to be crafting, you need to go start researching traits. And it's got to be save level all one. Of your gear. It doesn't have to be level one.
Level one.
It just has to have that trait. Straight
from the beginning.
It just has to have that trait. But yeah, it's something you should start early on, because once you get to the end, once you have like 8 traits and you need to craft that 9th, or 7 and you need to craft the 8th, it's like fucking 12, 15, 20 days, like fucking Clash of Clans times. Like, it takes forever.
Even if you're not completely convinced you want to do it, it's the same thing with, like, if you're new to the game, just broaden your horizons, just fucking try everything.
Yeah.
I didn't know I was going to like to be a sneaky boy. I created a sneaky boy.
And a really good way to make money, too, is when you're running around doing stuff, doing delves, killing random stuff, you know, on your way to get sky shards and lore books and through the story and stuff like that. All of the gear that you get that you're not equipping on your character, which you shouldn't, because you should have all training gear if you're wanting to make sure you're leveling fast, then fuck it. Just go with level one training gear. That's what I do. Fucking, your gear doesn't matter if you're fucking level 50 anyway. So, get that extra XP, man. So, 7% what smart. What I do is I'll save all of my stuff. I'll throw it all in my bank. And then as soon as my bank's full, I'll go to my crafting character and then I'll deconstruct all that shit. So number one, you get all the XP from deconstructing all that shit. Number two, if you're putting skill points into crafting, which is something that you probably should do early on, mm-hmm. just so you can get, because there's one of the passives will get you like more materials and stuff when you deconstruct things.
Yeah.
So if you do that, then you're getting more materials. You're getting more of the materials that you use to like make stuff better, mm-hmm. like give it to like a legendary or epic or whatever.
Rarity.
Improve it. Yeah, to improve the rarity. And those things are expensive.
Like the flux.
So if you're just doing that, you can make a good amount of gold just doing that. And then the very last thing that I wanted to go over was gold. If you're wanting to make sure. I think it's good because you're going to need gold for several things.
Eventually.
Paying crafters to make you gear if you're not crafting and you need some of those low crafting sets.
Good thing my brother's a crafter.
Trading, yeah. My only like good stuff right now is all medium, because that's what I've been doing. All my like light armor stuff is fucking nothing, and I've been.
Good thing my Dragon Knight uses medium armor.
All my staffs are 8 though right now, so all my staffs are pretty much done. I just need to get Nurnhone stuff, which is expensive, but whatever. So for gold, what I usually do, and it's good for the Ledger Domain skill line and for the Thieves Guild skill line, if you're wanting to get some of those passives, a lot of the Ledger Domain ones are really good. Mm-hmm. The Thieves Guild ones, some of them are pretty good too. They give you like kickback and stuff when you're stealing.
Honestly, the most important part about the Dark Brotherhood for me is just those daily Sithis bonus rewards are insane. Like, if when you do the daily, that's you get your Sithis bonus. Like, you get those Sithis set.
Yeah, the Sithis set is good. What I use those for is to get the motifs.
It's like Sithis's touch?
Yeah, it's Sithis's touch set.
Holy cow, that's so many S's.
Sithis's touch.
Sons of Sithis talk about Sithis's touch set.
Fucking hell. but no, I use those so you can get motifs. So you can sell those off and make a show.
Get those motifs, dude. Yeah. That's a lot of gold. How to make gold? Get motifs.
Yeah, do whatever will get you motifs. But what I do too, and it will make you a lot of gold, if you max out your fencing every single day. So if you go, I go to this place, this little town Voss in Vardenfell. Literally every time I've gone there, and maybe this is bad that I'm saying this on the podcast, every time I go there, there's fucking no one there. There's no one there. There's like literally, I'll go there and just steal. I'll pickpocket them twice and then kill them, which is what you'd try to do or whatever, if you can. And literally, there's like 10 people. I'll do like a little lap around the city, and then I'll come back. And by the time I get to the end, the last person has respawned, and then now I can kill them and go and keep doing it. And I'll do that until my inventory is full, and then I'll go ditch all the stuff to the fence, and then come back and do it again until I max out the fencing. But
God damn.
it doesn't take me that long. But it can get you like a good amount of gold.
Yeah.
I will only do one thing I would suggest too, if you're gonna do that, only take the stuff that's over 100 gold just to make it worth your while. Those
Yeah.
drop fairly frequently, and all the other stuff that's like 40 gold and shit isn't really worth your time. I would just stick with the
Yeah.
100 gold
Over a
stuff.
hundy.
And then yeah, that's pretty much it for this. Do you have anything else you want to say on gold, deconstructing, crafting? You haven't really touched a whole lot of that.
'Cause I don't do any of that. I'm not a crafter yet,
Yeah.
honestly. I want to try it. I'm not a sneaky boy
Just
either.
start just
I'm
start
not a
with
crafter
doing
or a sneaky boy,
just start
so
with doing the writs, man.
yeah.
Just go get certified and do the little writs.
Honestly, my biggest message here, just have fun. This game is so much fun.
It's such a
Just
fun game.
whatever you think you'll enjoy, fucking do it, dude.
Do whatever you want, man. Don't
Have
take our words with a fucking grain of salt. Do whatever you want.
Yeah. Literally whatever you want. Whatever's gonna make you happy.
Yeah, if you
And
think
tame
if
her
you
young.
want to grind your ass to level 50 as fast as possible and then start hitting that end game con in end of game, Jesus Christ,
End game
end
content.
game content.
You were so
Holy
good this whole
hell.
episode
I
without
know,
tongue
and now I
slips.
fuck it up. Then do it, man. If that's what you want to hit, then go for it.
You want to soak it in,
If you
enjoy
want
the journey.
to play all the quests and never talk to anyone, then that's what
Hell
then
yes,
I'll tell
I
you right
agree with
now.
you.
I'll tell you right now, that's exactly what I did when I started playing
Dude,
ESO.
especially
Probably like
like.
my first like 150 hours in ESO were just playing around in the storylines and going to all the different places
It's
and fucking around
that
and
same thing I said, like
making a bunch
in
of stupid ass
Skyrim,
named
like
characters.
you just do whatever, and in this, like, it's a whole new universe of just shit you can do
Well, and
with
it's
Elder
like,
Scrolls, so it's just dope.
it's a game, man. Like, there's no rules to playing it. Like, do whatever the fuck you
Even
want.
with the builds, like, honestly, you don't have to follow the build exactly if you don't want to. Just fucking do whatever, dude.
Yeah.
Whatever
And
you
if you
have fun
want to,
with.
there's no shame in doing it. You're probably gonna have a badass character. Like, do whatever you
Exactly.
want,
You're gonna
man.
shred me in PvP.
Yeah.
So,
Get
I'm sure
fucking
that'll be fun for
melted.
me. I'll have a lot of fun with that.
But when you kill someone, it'll be great because it was your kill that you
Because
made.
it doesn't happen very often.
Like, look, I got this kill and it is mine.
Then just turn
And then just squat on his body.
just turn super toxic.
And then just teabag him with.
I didn't even go off a build, dude. I just made this and I killed you.
I literally have no passives. Just toxic as fuck. No, this isn't Rocket League. This isn't
Overwatch.
Overwatch. No toxicity. Don't worry
Again,
though, the
ESO
community's
has a
awesome.
great community. Very positive. Join a guild, save your life, dude.
Well, one thing I noticed too is like, dude, I remember playing World of Warcraft.
World of
World of
Warcraft. That's
Warcraft.
what he said.
And getting my ass like chewed out by
Excuse
people,
me.
dude, for like when I wasn't healing well or like I
Oh my
didn't
God,
understand something.
toxic.
Like, not that I think all of World of Warcraft is toxic, just it's just a people thing. And it's the same thing with ESO. I've run into people that are kind of dicks, but like it's fucking people. Some
It's a
people are
game.
dicks, but like
It's a
I feel
game.
like
Happens.
generally my experience in ESO, now that I'm, 500, 600 hours, I'm knee deep in ESO for sure at this point.
Like half shin.
Half shin. I'm pretty deep into the ESO content that like I really feel like it's a really positive community. It's
Yeah,
honestly like
generally positive.
kind of surprised me because usually
Honestly,
like
more
that's
than
how it
generally.
well honestly that's kind of how it starts out and then all of a sudden it takes a turn because I remember like in Overwatch when I first started playing Overwatch it was not that bad.
Dude, when we stopped playing Overwatch, shit was like unbearable.
It sometimes just gets insane. And I don't know if it's just whatever level you're at or
It's just
like.
it rubs off. And when one dude's pissed, it makes me pissed. And then when I get
And
pissed,
then you
Cody gets
start
pissed.
saying shit to people and then they get pissed and they
Oh
start.
my
It's the
God.
same
And
thing
it's
with
like it
like
just rubs
with
off.
Rocket League 2 that we played for a little while that like, oh
Oh
my
my
God.
God. One dude says
What a
calculated,
save.
and we're
What a save.
fucking like,
What a save.
we're just
Fucking
out
hell,
for
man.
vengeance. The nice part about that kind of stuff is ESO. The majority of people are positive, and so it kind of rubs off on you. Some dude's really nice to you. You're like, fuck, this is
Well,
kind
now
of
that
fun.
that guy
Like,
said that to you, just saying, hey man, the guards are really strong and pretty much invincible. don't attack them.
Yeah.
That's not like Skyrim.
And I like sent him a whisper back and I was just like, thanks, dude.
Thanks, man. Yeah. That's like, well, and it makes me want to. It's the same thing when like someone said something to me and they were just like, hey, man, you have 12K health. Did you remember to eat your food? And I was like, oh, shit. I don't have, like, honestly, the first time this happened to me, like, I was doing a dungeon. I was probably like level 30 or 40 something. And with the first character I leveled. And someone just said something to me and just said, hey, man, you have like 11K or 10K health or some shit. Have you eaten food or anything? And I like, oh, like, I haven't really eaten food at all.
You're like, I just ate ramen.
Am I supposed to?
I made it on the stove.
I just ate Wendy's like an hour ago. But then he told me, he was just like, well, food is really important in ESO to boost like your stats and stuff. And then he literally gave me food. I didn't give him any gold. Like, he just like, here, man, let me give you some food. And he gave me food.
Aspire to be that kind of player.
Yeah, like, and if you notice something, don't be a dick about it. Just
don't be like, man, why are you at 12K health? Just be like, hey, are you, like, you good?
You need food? Well, it's like, I think it's good just
going through
a couple.
That's a good way to approach it. Do you need food?
Yeah, well, I think it's just, like, going through a little bit of checks before you do PvE stuff. Because that's, like, when I did the trial, like, the chick that was running it, she, soul gems isn't really a problem because you'll get so goddamn many of them. But like,
especially undone.
Make sure you don't put them in your fucking bank
and forget.
Yeah, like, you'll have them. But like, it's just like when we were doing the trial, the chick that was running it mentioned it a couple times before we got to the trial. Everyone, make sure you got your food, you got your pots, like potions or whatever. Make sure you've got everything ready. Make sure all your gear is fixed. Make sure you don't need to, you know, charge anything. If something, because you don't want to be in the middle of a fight and then go, oh, fuck, I need to charge my staff or whatever, you know. So
super,
like,
helpful.
It's just good to make supportive. Sure. Yeah, and you don't have to be a dick about it. You're just like, hey, guys, make sure you've got everything ready to go. We're about to go fuck up these big old kitties.
Yeah, the twins.
You know, so.
All right.
But yeah, there we go. Beginner's guide. If we fucked up anything, let us know in the comments. I would say, too, if there's anything you guys have tips-wise for us, let us know on Twitter or in the comments here on our Libsyn or anywhere. If there's better ways to level, better ways to get gold, let us know. These are the best ways that I've found personally. So
best things I've watched videos
about. I'm sure there's probably better ways to do it. I don't know, but this is what I've found to be the best that works for me.
Personally,
have fun.
It's fun.
Yeah, have fun.
I kind of love this one.
Yeah, fun times. Take us out, Dusty.
Thank you for tuning in to the Sons of Sithis podcast. We hope you've enjoyed. For any questions or updates, follow our Twitter at Sons of Sithis. And if you have any suggestions, send it to our Gmail at sonsofsithis@gmail.com.
Spill some blood for me, dear sister.